Ladies and gentlemen, before you hear it on the news, I'm going to tell you myself. About an hour ago, we had an incident where one of the employees stuck their arm through the cage and a tiger tore her arm off. I can give you your money back or I can give you a rain check.
When you got injured, did you go, oh no, a man with a bleached mullet who's not an EMT and dressed like one is going to try to save my life?
Yeah, no, I don't think I even remember what he was wearing on the day.
Make a sweep through the park and make sure there's no other customers somewhere else in the park, please.
I had more pressing priorities to worry about.
Did you watch the actual footage of the attack?
I have, over and over, yes sir.
Oh my gosh, over and over.
So get your gun in there.
Get everything out of the driveway. Give me a stretcher, out of the gun.
They're getting it. There was a time and place where we actually used it as a safety video.
Did he ever give you any money for that? Or was he like, no fucking way?
No, I mean, we didn't even have any further of a conversation than this should be the one thing people need to see before they decide if this is a career move they want to make.
Do you have any regrets about your time with Joe?
Sure. Oh, yeah.
Give me your top 200. No, I'm kidding. What's in the top five?
It's been in the back of my head, and I think about it a lot. A lot of times when we put cats down and they use me because just by my appearance or my voice, you know, I could get a cat up inside of a cage where we could dart it and tranquilize it so they could be put down and stuff.
Did Joe realize how important you were to the zoo to keep it going?
I don't think so, because numerous times he had told me that I couldn't run the zoo, that I wouldn't know how to run the zoo. Numerous times he told me that, but he always tried to keep everybody smaller than him.
Right. And did you ever say anything like, well, you don't know how to pick a hairdresser?
Yeah. No, his mullet was pretty much, that was pretty much him. That's his insignia, so.
Hey, I'm Joe Exotic, otherwise known as the Tiger King, the gay gun cane redneck with a mullet.
Did you ever see him kill a lion or tiger?
I did. I saw him shoot two tigers, actually. One of them because he was pissed off at the tiger because the tiger nearly bit him one day. The guy was a cruel man.
Joe admitted to shooting some of the tigers outright. Were you outraged by that?
Yes. Obviously I was. But at that point, it's out of my control. Joe always had a way of explaining his action. So they were owed. They were injured. They were suffering is what we got.
Now, I'm really shifting gears here, but do you think Joe should be free? Do you think he should be a free man?
No. Not no, but fuck no.
Yeah.
22 years doing federal time. What's that guy? Like 56, something like that? Yeah, he's going to die in there, so.
Yeah.
Good riddance.
Oh, all right. Wow. That is a powerful statement. Were you surprised when he was found guilty on all 19 counts?
No, I wasn't. I wouldn't. People in Oklahoma hate Joe Exotic. He's gay. This is a very red state, and us gay folk are very, we're almost an endangered species here. But other reasons, you know, animal violations, stuff like that.
But you clearly liked working there. You worked there for a long time, and yet Joe seemed to be quite an asshole. And how do you rectify that?
Yeah, you just look at your day and you just go on with it. We got into plenty of verbal fights. But he was always belittling somebody. I mean, always. I mean, he just got to where it was all about the cameras, and he would fire somebody just because he needed to fire somebody.
Problem with that? Having the cameras run on the morning meetings set Joe off. It was like lighting a firecracker.
And if you think it's funny, you can pack your shit and go right now. Because the disrespect around this place is ending today.
You're the slacker, and you do less than anybody here. Ain't gonna work with me, so you need to find a new job.
Did Joe ever try anything romantically with you?
No. Joe's type is young and dumb. He wants him 17, 18 years old. And me as a 31-year-old person, I aged out about 12 years ago. So I never had to worry about anything like that with Joe.
So Joe, he dedicated a song to you. And was it flattering? Was it embarrassing? Was it alarming? Do you remember the words?
No, I don't exactly remember the words. Some of them were bad, some of them were great, some of them were just way off the wall.
and that clearly not his voice. There's been tons of press about it not being his voice.
That is not him singing.
My first two albums that I did, this is my first album, I Saw Tiger, and this is my second album, Starstruck. And there's 28 songs and 16 music videos.
'Cause I saw Tiger, now I understand. I saw Tiger, Tiger saw me.
When did you first realize the real danger of his flamboyant persona? I mean, what was the moment you went, oh wait, this might all go away?
You know, I began, about 3 months in, I began to see him do things to animals that I knew was wrong. And as I have admitted, I sold out my own journalistic integrity by not just going to the authorities or to an animal rights activist and saying, hey, you need to come in and stop this guy, because the things that I saw were wrong. Joe was terrified of big cats. He was scared to death of lions and tigers. And in the shots that you see in there where he's in with the two tigers, the white one and the white one is blind and the other one is on tranquilizers.
It goes on. Ow, son of a bitch. God damn you.
Here's all these people filming Joe being dragged around and nobody's going in there to rescue him.
Get out! Go! Get!
And nobody helped me. Nobody.
Get out of here, you bitch!
It's idiotic to think how he's become famous as the Tiger King when he's so terrified of big cats.
Wow, I did not know that. Do you think he's skipping around his cell, or do you think he's punching the wall?
I'll be honest with you. I don't think Joe Exotic will leave prison alive. I don't think he'll be able to stand it. Even if he got out with good behavior in 10, 12 years, he won't live that long. You know, I'll tell you what's really eating him up is people like me who are getting so much attention instead of him. He doesn't get any of the money that's coming out. He doesn't get any of the accolades. He doesn't get any of the opportunities. He doesn't get anything except 3 meals a day.